Hello there, my name is Thomas Ruolo and welcome to my YouTube channel where we talk all things trading, finances and money in general. And today, something really special. I am joined by my friend and partner, Alessandro Pietrocola, an amazing individual who is gonna help me explain to you guys what a hedge fund is, how difficult it is to open a hedge fund, and just in general, we'll talk a little bit about the hedge funds. So if you are not subscribed to my YouTube channel just yet, please do so and hit that notification bell so that you're notified when I make a new upload. And yeah, we're very formal today. We are important because we're talking about hedge funds. But in reality, you know me, I'm not a suit wearer. It's just the influence of Alessandro. So yeah, we'll try to keep it serious, to the point, yet fun as always. So Alessandro, welcome to my YouTube channel.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming by, for stopping by.
My pleasure.
You can send me the invoice later and I will cry from the amount of money you're going to charge me for these 10 minutes. But thank you very much. And well, a little bit intro of Alessandro. You've been into fintech for a long time.
Yeah, I've been into fintech for a long time. So I have like some 18 years in this sector. And I was very happy to receive this invitation from Thomas because there is a lot to talk in this topic, and fintech, it's some kind of new words with many people not really understand what exactly it is. So I'm trying to explain with simple words what you can do and how better you can figure it out.
Right, because the world of hedge funds and in general, what people usually think when they think of a hedge fund is a billion-dollar thing, cars, yachts, and the Wolf of Wall Street, really, Jordan Belfort. But in reality, a hedge fund, from what I've actually, what we've started doing with you already as well, is it's ever so slightly different from what people expect of it.
Yeah, basically, it's more about the fund itself. I mean, if we want to put in a very few and simple word, the fund itself is just a partnership between the person who manage the investment and the people who pull the money in. So the word hedge, it became very popular, especially in the last year, due of course to Wall Street and Hollywood and Wolf of Wall Street and all the movie. So it just became much more popular. It's just a way to identify a type of investment that are classified as high risk and for accredited investors. So typically the accredited investors are people that, of course, are quite wealthy, they know the risk they are involved in, and they are ready to have huge loss. They can have today plus 20, another day minus 10, and so on. So they are kind of ready for it.
Right, so in super layman terms, then a hedge fund is nothing more than a company that has a legal right and a license, so to speak, to accept an investment in a way of money from a third party. So if we want to advertise our financial service as an investment company, a hedge fund, investment bank, whatever, then this is basically the whole concept. And then there are different levels of hedge funds with different levels of what we can do, what we cannot do, and that's gonna also impact the amount of licenses that we need to get, etc.
Exactly. So I would say that a typical hedge fund involve at least two companies. If you want to talk from the legal point of view, or can be just a company and a legal partnership, there are some jurisdiction where there are some simplified, like British Virgin Islands, where you have much more simplified structure. But typically, yes, if we want to have a very clear idea is typically it's a company where the money are going in and they are managed by the investment firm or the investment manager or general partner, how we want to call.
Yeah.
And the profit are distributed between all the investors. And each investor, of course, is going to pay a fee to the investor, to the investment manager. So that's the reason why it's very interesting from a trader, because everybody dream to make money trading people money. So that's I think what the appeal for young trader and you can go You can invest in stock, you can or leverage products or crypto or whatever. You
know? Anything.
But obviously for hedge, it's much more popular, speculative. So, real estate market, for example, it's not so speculative as a leverage product, right. Leverage stocks or crypto or an ECO or whatever, you know better than me.
Sure, I understand that. Well, for example, if me, that has been quite a dream for me as well as a an active trader for so many years. I've always was, you know, also somehow amazed by this concept of building my own hedge fund to a certain extent that, you know, at some point have $1 billion under management. But then I also always thought that I would need a huge office, 200 employees. But in reality, can you tell in a few words how this very first step, even for me as Tom Scrollo, if I want to, that's what we're actually doing, but for our, for my followers and your followers as well, to explain in three words. So if an active trader with good track record, he is looking to become this first level of a hedge fund or an investment company, to have that first super basic level of a right to accept money from a third party. So what would be the first step? How much time would it take and how much would it cost?
So first of all, it really depends where he's located and where the hedge fund will be operating and which market he will target. Because he may be located in Europe and use an European fund or an American fund and may target, I don't know, Chinese market, for example, you know? Yeah. Or you may have a fund targeting American market. So there are different rules. But if we're talking about the easiest way, typically, it's not so expensive. You don't need to have a million people, usually two director and a compliance officer.
Wow. So like under five people could be actually a hedge fund.
Absolutely. I mean, for the very beginning, I read the last book of Raleigh Principle, and he told until he had 180 million under management, he had five people and he was run from his New York flat.
From New York flat, guys.
So it's...
Can you imagine, guys, $180 million, right, under management and just five people from his own flat? So this just gives you a good perspective. This is something I did not know before, that this is how you can run a hedge fund. So it's not about a fancy office, $1 million investment into licenses and all this kind of stuff and huge staffing. It's about results.
It's about, absolutely. Result is the king. So. If, and this is something what I always say to everybody, result is the king. Your investor does not care how cool you are or where you live or what you do. They want to see the number. So if you have a track record of what you have done for yourself and you have a clear vision of what you want to do with the money what you're going to collect from your investor, then you are most likely going to be very successful in this.
Right. Well, this. So, for example, if you're taking that somebody, some simple trader who is putting together, let's say, stock portfolios in United States stocks. And some crypto. Okay,
yeah,
so this
absolutely.
Is the two one most popular things on the market right now, and he's doing quite well, and he wants to start a really simple fund in United States. So I know that, for example, Dubai is opening up right now, and that's also the reason why we're both in Dubai.
Absolutely.
But let's take United States and putting together stock portfolios and some crypto portfolios for third party. What would be, you know, just rough estimate in terms of the cost and the time duration that would be required?
Well, the most popular jurisdiction in and most popular structure as well is Delaware. Probably in US there are more company registered in Delaware than people living there, but Delaware is typically a very good jurisdiction for establish your hedge fund. So again, it's very difficult to say in a few words, but just to be very simple, let's suppose that you don't want to have more than 35 investor and you keep your profile low, so you're looking for an accredited investors into your investment, then you could start from $20,000 to $30,000 already to have a very winning structure that put you on the go.
Yeah, well, very interesting. Well, that's also that's something we've spoken about before, and you did explain to me before that There are so many rules, so many different regulations, yeah. different countries.
And yes, that, absolutely.
You know, is it possible for someone to do it themselves, or it's better to, for example, because I know that you do private consultations, right, on this, any topic of fintech. So fintech, by the way, is not just hedge funds. It's also opening your forex brokerage or, you know,
payment institution, payment gateway, whatever.
Anything that is chain, financial technology.
Yeah, yeah, everything with this financial technology related,
right.
It goes under the fintech. Well, obviously, you need to have a profile. I mean, it's suggested that you have a professional that follow you. And something what I always say to all my clients is have done many times for myself. I am myself a fintecher, and I have a team of lawyer, compliance, and accountant with me. So when you come to have a consultation with me, you don't have a view only from legal point of view,
yeah.
but you kind of taking this expertise of my 17, 18 years this summer right. doing this. I have 3 licenses where I am acting as yeah. the director on my exact name. Apart from the old license, I help clients well, to think. So yeah,
you're also a FCA regulated.
I'm FCA regulated in UK, and I'm a like financial service provider in New Zealand as well.
Well, I know that you have offices in UK, Dubai, Singapore.
UK, Dubai, Singapore is our main hub, and for a financial service provider, we do in New Zealand as well.
New Zealand as well. Yeah. By the way, if anybody is interested in knowing more about this kind of a topic of opening your own hedge fund or any fintech topic in general, then there's going to be all the links down in the description to Alessandro's channels, the website, and everything else to contact. So contact Alessandro if you need help with this kind of a topic, because Alessandro has a crap ton of experience in this, and I've spent a few evenings obviously speaking to him about this, a few dinners, and I'm just amazed by how many smallest details.
A lot of small details. If we wanna go to the fintech top jurisdiction, I would say that the majority of structures you can have in US, UK, Emirates, United Arab Emirates, Singapore, Hong Kong, and New Zealand. These are my favorite top 6 jurisdiction in the world in terms of fintech. So there is yeah. tons of different things, and it really depends. Sometimes people ask me, what is the faster or cheaper way to have a fund or to have a company? It really yeah. depends where you are located, what exactly you want to do, your business ideas, which market are you targeting, and how you are doing, and what is your average size? For example, coming back to the hedge fund, are you looking for $5,000 investor, or are you looking for $1 million investor?
Right,
are you looking for people who are high risk or not high risk? They are in private equity or not private equity?
Yeah.
Startup. I mean, there are millions things what we need to sit and discuss before I can even suggest where could be for you the best jurisdiction yeah. to start. And after, it depends also where you live in, because maybe you live in Europe and maybe there is not double taxation agreement. I just tell something.
Yeah.
There is not just double taxation agreement with jurisdiction where you open your fund and you have many problem in tax, and also your investor have same problem in tax.
Yeah.
So it also depends where you're located. Maybe you may consider this something also what I advise to relocate to the top jurisdiction. Obviously, if you are in UK or in US or in Dubai or Singapore or Hong Kong mm-hmm. or New Zealand, you obviously have much more better
right.
condition than if you stay where you are. It's not mandatory to move, but obviously it's kind of better.
Right, absolutely.
No, of course.
That's what we are doing here. And you, Alessandro, you're moving from UK to Dubai as well. I hope that's going to happen soon.
Yeah, absolutely.
Myself personally, I've moved to Dubai as well for so many benefits, because the whole world is just going crazy. And we are here basically continuing to live and to build our dreams. And this is the place, I think, as one of the sheikhs has said, that they're going to be making Dubai one of the best city to live by 2040. I believe, to be honest, that this is already one, if not the best city to live in by now. And the thing,
absolutely.
That's why I think that, would you say that you would recommend, if the person would be free to choose, would it be Dubai for fintech?
Absolutely. Dubai, it comes for, have lots of benefit. So it's very, very interesting, very, very interesting city to come. Mm-hmm. Obviously, it's kind of new jurisdiction, so have not the history of United States and UK in term of finance, but they eradicate a lot of the common law, what is very strong in UK and in US, and they try to simplify and attract people to Dubai in a way that it's going to be faster to get licensed or to get regulated, and it's going to be cheaper in terms of tax, and there are lots of other benefit that you may have if you will relocate to the UAE.
Right,
so in this term.
Okay, very, very nice, very just amazing, because again, as I said before, for me, a topic of hedge fund, even when I've been in my prime wake of making good money in the markets, I was always thinking that hedge fund is just a multi-million or a billion-dollar thing.
And
to just sum up, so basically, you just need a few people to start about $30,000, around that to spend on all the legalization part, legal part, the corporate part. And then you can start basically slowly building that portfolio.
Absolutely. Something what I always suggest is not to think too big, not compare yourself with people who is on level 20. So just have winning ideas and a winning strategy in terms of investment with a good track record. It's already more than enough to attract investor.
Yeah.
And after from that, you can go and attract more investor or have different strategy under one fund. So you may have different portfolio, or you may have segregated fund. So, I mean, you can have different type of different type.
You
of
can fund. Start developing.
Of course, you can start developing. But for the very beginning, like for every fintech, or even for the payment, you can start up with some $20,000. You don't need to, people thinking, I want to do payment, I think about Revolut. I want to do hedge fund, I think about, Vanguard or Goldman Sachs. You know, so it's not the best way to start, but it's very good to have an idea and to explain why this idea is convenient and what is your strategy in terms
Understood.
Of investment.
Absolutely. Understood. Well, Alessandro, my pleasure. Thank you very much.
Pleasure was mine.
This is, you know, in simple words, the world of hedge funds. And in reality, it's breaking all the stereotypes.
Absolutely.
Because all of us keep thinking of hedge funds as a multi-million dollar super yachts and those unachievable levels of Berkshire Hathaway and some investment banks, as you know, Goldman Sachs and stuff like that. But in reality, a lot of those hedge funds and investment banks, they started as a garage party, just like, you know, Microsoft or Apple. And so absolutely, and this is the reality. And any of you, if you're an active trader and you have made good income
result.
And you have a good track record and you're ready to build those low risk portfolios and show that good results and low risk, and want to go into actually acquiring some assets for management and manage other people's and companies' assets. So it's not really that difficult, but you should consider clicking on one of the links and checking out Alessandro and his service. And he has an incredible side business, which is consulting. So you can always set up a meeting with Alessandro and he will explain to him exactly what you're doing, how you're doing it. And then he will tell you exactly what you need and what's your best jurisdiction and the best how to settle all those formalities in the most efficient way possible. So if you've enjoyed this video, please hit the crap out of that like button, and I mean it. And please subscribe and let me know down in the comments if you actually knew all of this information or this is all new to you as well. And please let me know, maybe we could do some other videos with Alessandro as well. We'll be more than happy to share and to open up, you know, to break some more stereotypes from supposedly a high up financial world. And as always, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next videos. And Alessandro, thank you very much.
Thank you. As well. My pleasure.
Thank you. Cheers.
Cheers.